What is up, guys? My name is Zahreddin. This is going to be our very first biohacking with me session. So today I have an interesting product I've been using for the past couple of months and I think is really worth your time. It's called Dirty Mouth Toothpowder. It's a natural, all natural kind of alternative to toothpaste. And what's really cool about it is that, like, after using it for like a month, 2 months, I felt that my teeth are a lot better off in comparison to like fluoride conventional toothpaste. However, going back to the dentist, going back to the doctor, there isn't any real difference between the two. It's just more of like a feeling, but let's get into it. So what's the difference between Dirty Mouth Toothpowder and normal toothpaste and powders? Number one, you have surfactants. So normal toothpaste and toothpowders, a surfactant is like what you get in like the detergent used for your clothes. When you really want something that you use for your clothes, that you get muddy, you get dirty all the time, you're gonna be using that on the same on your teeth. Teeth, which are organic material, a lot weaker than the polymers and all the threads that make up your clothing. The secondary thing is that with toothpaste and tooth powders, these surfactants, they destroy both good and bad bacteria. Studies within the past couple of years, especially out of Austria and Europe, have been indicating that not all bacteria are bad. And not all bacteria in the oral cavity are bad. In particular, there is a strain of bacteria called Bliss K12 and Bliss 18 that are particularly useful when it comes to preventing bad breath for individuals right after sleep. They are essentially like your bodyguards that kill off a lot of that bad bacteria. So with these preservatives, especially potassium benzoate, sodium benzoate, they have been linked to cancer in other forms, not necessarily in the paste form, but within a powder form, within a liquid medium. So just kind of going back to first principles thinking, does it make sense to put something that in another form is bad for you in your mouth if it has never been tested? Glycerin. So this is the big bad boss by a lot of companies trying to sell you that organic toothpaste. Glycerin is added to toothpaste to create that pleasant texture, you know, that smoothness that you get. So without the glycerin, your toothpaste feels very rough, like just right out of the dentist. Hydrated silica. So this ingredient removes debris and stains and is a common mild abrasive. So over time, it can damage the tooth. And when it comes to like enamel strengthening toothpaste, they're trying to remove this hydrated silica form all the time. So PLO's Dirty Mouth Tooth Powder contains all the necessary components of the other organic branded toothpaste and powders. Bentonite and kaolinite are components that act as mild abrasives, kind of reducing the acidity of your mouth, remineralizing your teeth, reinvigorating with micro minerals and things like that, but also trying to keep the good bacteria while eliminating the bad bacteria here. Kaolinite in particular, it whitens and polishes your teeth. And PLO's Dirty Mouth Tooth Powder, within its ingredients, contains baking soda. Baking soda is like the number one ancient 10,000 year old kind of cleaner that everyone from the dawn of civilization to now has used. It is that thing that you use for cleaning. It is that thing that you use for clothing when you don't have any soap. It's what you use to clean animals, to brush hide, everything. To clean your own body, you use baking soda. So baking soda is that chemical, that compound that we've used for 10,000 years, knowing all of the benefits of baking soda for those past 10,000 years. And then it contains essential oils for freshness, to give you that little that feeling of freshness after utilizing it. So I've been using the tooth powder for the past 2-ish months. And what I've noticed the most here is that, number one, when you first use it, you feel like, and then you're like, you brush your tongue across your mouth or across your teeth or whatever, you kind of feel like you just come out of the dentist. Like you had like this rejuvenating experience and your teeth feel clean. You can feel every ridge, every corner, every turn, all that fun stuff that like coming right out, straight out of the dentist. And so what I try and attribute this to is the bentonite and kaolinite clay, really being that mild abrasive cutting down on a lot of the plaque that's within your teeth and really helping you out to give you that kind of nice feel. Additionally, because the bentonite and kaolinite are removing the fluoride, are removing the glycerin in particular, which is causing that really smooth feel that you get from the conventional toothpaste, this is kind of where the bentonite and kaolinite do their part. Secondarily, I've noticed that with like the tooth powder, my teeth have become a lot more sensitive. And I think this is just because as you lose all the glycerin that's kind of coating your teeth, your nerves become more exposed, your teeth become more exposed in general. So you start to feel a lot of these things that a lot of the sensitivities from eating, from like blowing across your teeth with more emphasis than you would have felt beforehand. Now, if you wanted to try this for like a month, it would be cool. But to continuously utilize this dirty mouth tooth powder day, month in, month out, it'll cost you like $34. Regular toothpaste is like five or like three for like a bottle, for like a tube. So economically, it doesn't make sense. Now, the cool thing about it is that you can make this entire dirty mouth tooth powder on your own. A lot of people just get the raw ingredients, mash it up together, mix it, and they create their own powder on their own. And I think if you have a mind to do this, this is probably the best option for you. So what do I think? I think this is a really good product, especially for starting out within the biohacking sphere, for really understanding what does one ingredient do versus another ingredient. What is the active ingredient in this that really causes this feeling of like smoothness versus roughness in comparison with like conventional products? But it's very pricey. Are you going to really realistically want to spend $34 every month for something that's only going to last like a month, a little bit more than that? I don't think so. But the shipping time, the shipping cost, all these associated costs. Now, you can make this on your own. You can go and get every ingredient on your own for like $3. And I think that is probably more cost effective if you're of the mind to continue utilizing something like this. I will personally continue utilizing dirty mouth tooth powder and making my own on the side, especially as this becomes kind of out of a student budget. But I think that for everyone who is looking to try something new, this is something that you can really go for. All right, guys, if you like this content and are looking for more, please join this community. Engage with me. Engage with everyone around in this community. We're just starting out fresh. I'm really hoping that a lot of you guys can come on, can share your stories, can share your experiences. And until next time, take care.